Talking of peace, see, 2020 today looks to me like talking of love in times of corona. All over the world, it is on fire. Conflicts of various variety and various layers. Conflict over access and control of natural resources, where people are brutalized, criminalized, and their movements are suppressed. Conflict between religious communities. Islamophobia is the biggest legitimizing factor for modern state in the present state. A social contract is broken. Those who are elected by the general will of the people to govern the public affairs do not fulfill their obligations toward those people. They are siding with only one section and fulfilling their things. And that is also generating a lot of conflicts. In our subcontinent, particularly in India, the caste conflicts, the conflicts of identities in various forms, these are the conflicts in which the daily life of a person of society is challenged with. Now when we talk from where this idea of peace movement comes, it comes from the anti-war movements after Second World War. And all the peace movements in Europe and all those places, their backbone has been a sentiment against the war. So if you like to look from that point of view, our subcontinent has never had a real experience of war of that variety. From Japanese side it was confined till Burma, and this side it has never come. So our people in general have never experienced or sense what was experienced in Europe, Japan and America and other. In Europe you don't find a single village which was not affected during the Second World War. So everyone knows the horror of the war, and they are from heart against war. So you have a tradition of very strong anti-war movement, and that becomes the backbone of the peace movement. So because we don't have that kind of existence, that creates several kind of challenges before us. That yes, our efforts as a CNDP, IDPD, India-Pakistan People's Forum, what is the focus? Focus is foreign policy. Whenever we talk of anti-war or peace, we look at it from the point of view of foreign policy, whereas the real issues are the internal policy. You know, this idea started coming when we were doing this workshop with the school kids and trying to raise the issue how the children perceive peace. So when we came to know about their perception, their issues of peace start from the classroom. The conflict between the peer group, then in the society, then these community things. That's how children have expressed their thing, that their peace means that peace is required at all these levels. Just tackling the issue of India and Pakistan, and you think that whole of India, whole peninsular India has not seen any war. The war is confined to the northwest, few villages, few kilometers. How can we make them understand the importance of the issue of peace with this? So my point is, and I will not take much time, that the challenge before us, if we really want these peace efforts to become a movement, get mass support, we have to evolve strategies to become part of the daily struggles of survival of the people. The conflict and internal policies are as important. Whole issue of jingoism, war jingoism, Dr. Mitra has raised. What is this? It is result of internal politics. Our ruling parties need to keep these issues alive just to mobilize on emotional grounds and passionate grounds and not on real issues. We have seen results of 2019. 2019 is absolutely, I'm saying, I'm going to take a look at the court. उससे पहले सब हारे रखे थे पुलवामा बालाकोट से पहले ऑल द रिपोर्ट्स वर सेइंग दैट दे आर इन ट्रबल एंड ओनली वन स्ट्रोक हैज ब्रॉट देम बैक विद द ग्रेटर मेजर सो व्हाई शुड दे विल नेवर लीव इट इंडियाज फॉरेन पॉलिसी इज ओनली कन्फाइंड टू पाकिस्तान एंड चाइना इट्स ए मायोपिक ओनली बाइपोलर way our foreign policy and it is used anti-China is used to counter one kind of politics and anti-Pakistan is used to counter another kind of China because it still has a communist title so all left-wing resistance and everything is condemned by bringing China in and what is that resistance Majority of the population in India today from northeast to Kanyakumari to Kashmir, etc. is fighting for retain their access and control over natural resources. And these are the populations which are totally dependent on their access to natural. Natural resource is not resource for them. It is a source of livelihood. They survive and eat. Two meals a day because of their access to natural resources. And that natural resources have been transferred to the corporations and all those kind of things in the name of development. And whoever is resisting this thing and is saving their life, they are branded as Deshdrohis, urban Naxals, rural Naxals. Naxals also have now categories and you have all kind of things. Now, if you go to Datewada and Chhattisgarh or Manipur or Odisha, this is the peace issue for them. They want peace, but their peace is not confined to India-Pakistan border. Their peace is defined there. So, I have only one point to make that Whenever we get time, we should try to link all this disarmament, this, that movement to the daily struggles of the people. Only then we will be able to reach somewhere closer to becoming a peace movement. Thank you.